What we want to see and what we're looking to see is, what is the cognitive impact of CrossFit on people? Does it help them focus better? Does it help them think more clearly? Does it actually improve the function of their brain? And what better people to work with than teachers?
It really begs the question, what would happen if we take these 18 teachers, administrators, and put them into a box and let them experience it?
I really want to expose them to as many different workouts as I can. I want them to think about, what can I do with my class?
Can we turn on that light, like, yeah, that might be important to teach our students?
Oh, absolutely. I think it should be, you know, a beacon of light.
You can't force this team building or these bonding exercises, but you put them through CrossFit and it's amazing how close these people are going to get to each other.
Teachers need to take control of their health and fitness so they can be better role models for their students. This is our audience. This is who we're in front of for 8 hours a day.
They're going to see their lives changed.
Coach's got to lead from the front.
What's the line?
25 heavy swings, 25 burpees, 3 rounds.
I think the members have to see you bleed a little bit. They gotta see you working. They gotta see you doing what, practicing what you preach. You know, I can't come in here and yell people to go faster. And then here I am eating donuts and, you know, drinking energy drinks all day. You know, you gotta get out there and you gotta show them that, you know, it's for everybody.
In a respected establishment, you can't, you know, talk about knowing what you're doing unless you can actually do what you're doing.
Our business as box owners is providing value to our clients, and part of that is, you know, us making sure that we're in shape and making sure that we don't lose track of why we're doing this. We're doing this so I can be healthy for my kids 10 years from now. So I think it's really important.
Like, oh no.
You guys are still here.
We are still here. And we're first. Make note of that.
So are you like the head honcho among this group?
Nope, I am no one. Yeah, I am no different than anyone else in this group. I just got to go to the board meeting. Yeah.
Fall under, don't fall down. Fall under the ball.
How do you not fall backwards?
Because you gotta, like, no, be more here.
What is that?
More weight here.
But she says in your heels.
Yeah, right, but this too. Like, just not toes. Right, that's what I'm like.
I'll let her do the warm up, and then once we get them done with the warm up, then we usually split into half the group, split the group in half, and I'll work like a barbell movement, and Meredith will do gymnastics or something with the other half, and it's been working really well.
Lay around at home trying to think of this way to torture us.
Yeah. It takes about 2 weeks. I think if you can break down that barrier, because they trust me, I know what I'm doing, but I don't know if they trust me that I'm not gonna push them really, really hard or they're gonna get hurt. And now they do. And we've got that trust where if I tell them this is what they need to do, they're gonna do it.
I'm impressed with how much he knows and how well he can explain the movements and the function and the functionality of the movements, because I know that's a big part of CrossFit.
I guarantee you guys put stuff up on shelves all the time, or you pick up your kids from here and like put them up on the counter or like hold them up against the wall, whatever it may be. So we need that overhead strength. See, Michelle's got it.
I didn't want to be here today. It's raining. It's cold outside. I wanted to go home and get warm and snuggly and have lasagna.
But you're here.
But I'm here.
I missed one time I was sick. Yeah, so I didn't come to work, so I didn't feel like I could come to CrossFit, you know.
Oh, I've actually missed one class, but that was a geographical thing.
So you've been able to unplug.
Yeah.
For an hour.
Yeah.
And?
This is really freaking hard, man. Like, seriously, you can't think about anything else except getting through it.
After the third week, you know, we were going to wait another month before we had anything scheduled for a barbell to get in their hands. And we said, man, they're doing great. Let's put a barbell in their hands. Let's have them front squat. Let's have them press. And they loved it.
Let's go. Who is it that does this?
Steve really pushes me to go beyond where I ever would go on my own. So that's been huge. I can run 6 to 10 miles without breathing hard at all, and in here I can't breathe. So it's a big challenge.
To see them, how scared they were to put that bar on their neck and that front rack, to feel like, okay, wow, I can actually do this barbell, and they started putting weight on there. It was really cool to see some of those barriers get broken down.
I'm a lot stronger than I thought I was, and getting stronger every time. I've never tried some of these things before, so I didn't know I had it in me.
I mean, I've learned a little bit better how to like maneuver some of these weight stuff that like you always see at the gym, but you're like, I don't know what to do with it. So I mean, I feel like I have a more confidence in like the general gym accoutrements.
The biggest thing is I have way more energy at the end of the day when I get done. I'm more productive. I'm actually getting stuff done that I don't wait till the weekend. Does that make me lazy?
So I had to bring Gabriel with me because we don't have time to go back to school after class.
This is your boy?
He's my boy, my oldest.
Hi. What do you think about your mama working out hard in here?
She's good.
Well, we're trying to get them to get below parallel, and I told Anne that she could put some ab mass under here so that she can get down in parallel. Well, she went over and got 12 ab mats and sat down with 12 ab mats.
Anne did that. That wasn't me. It was Anne's idea.
Now let's try it with two and see what happens.
I think I have more energy. Well, there's a point where driving to work every day, I would be sleepy in the mornings because I have like a 35 minute drive to work. I don't have that anymore. Like I'm sitting at that light and I'm like, oh, I could just go to sleep now. Before I was. So I think that has to be a product of the CrossFit.
Now you got 7 of those. Control it the whole way down, yeah? I think it's super important because at some point, you're not gonna be able to get up from the toilet. You're not gonna be able to get up from the couch.
He's such a bleep. I can't believe he's a bleeping. You bleep.
I can't help it. You guys look like you're having fun up
here.
We
are having fun. Yeah. It's this group, I think, is what makes it.
It's the personality.
You should see us at funerals.
I know.
You know, we haven't had a good funeral in a while. Maybe Steve would volunteer.
Don't say that.
We're gonna do 8 rounds with 3 different exercises. So 24 total rounds of Tabata. So you'll do 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds rest, 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds rest, and we're gonna keep going through 3 different movements.
I've seen the relationships I've had with some of these members change just in a different way. To have my colleagues expose their weaknesses in front of me, you know, and talk to me about it, it just helps you get closer with the people that you work with.
I feel really good that Meredith feels that I've kind of pushed beyond, and I try every day to like push it, but I do keep into the back of my mind that I cannot destroy my knee. But I will agree, I'm doing more than I thought I was. I had a high tibial osteotomy, and basically it means you have a misalignment. What they have to do is they cut a wedge out of your shin, and then they take the bone from your hip. They fill in the bone that they removed. They slap 4 plates and 12 screws on there, and they say, do not put your foot on the ground for 12 weeks.
Like the competition, and that's what I'm finding out. Like I've always done like kind of the team stuff, but I really like just competing like one-on-one, like me with someone else. Just try to push myself and get that extra oomph that I wouldn't get like just doing weights on my own.
I'm pleasantly surprised with the participation. You know, I think when you do something with 18 new individuals that have never been exposed to CrossFit, you never know what you're gonna get.
They are doing really, really well. They're all showing up still. And it's freezing cold, rainy Monday, and midterms are next week. So the fact that we had this many people here is amazing. And a couple teachers said they wouldn't be able to be here, and they asked for, you know, wads they can do at home. So I gave them CrossFit Journal's travel wads, and they're like doing it.
Are you guys having fun out there? Even though you're working hard, you look like you're laughing. You guys are.
No, it's fun. It's definitely fun. But by the time you're done, you're like, how was that only like 12 minutes?
Yeah, really.
Because you're like working so hard.
It's not like they're coming here and dreading, you know, kind of walking in and, you know, head hanging. They come in and they're excited to work. And it's really cool to be a part of.
We're a mother-son team. He's gonna be doing CrossFit soon too.